God bless you. I want to talk with you because the Lord dropped something into my spirit last night. He reminded me of some things that I was lamenting over, things that I thought that weren't going my way. And then he brought me all the way up to the moment in which we now live in. And let me take a retrospective look back. Much like Joseph did in Genesis chapter 50, when he looked at all that his brothers had done to him, and then he looked back at them and said that you meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. And, you know, he let me know that sometimes, you know, things that I thought were for my breaking were literally for my making. And this is what he dropped in my spirit. He dropped two little nuggets in, and that's the subject of this particular video, is what I thought was for my breaking was literally for my making. What you thought was breaking time was making time. Then you're better because of what you've been through. And you know, you got sometimes the prayer for those that despitefully use you was that some of those folks actually blessed your life. You're better after the other side of your interlude with them. You're better after going several rounds with them. That literally some of the people that thought that they were dealing you a death blow have actually made you stronger. They made you better. Then, you know, sometimes when you give them, send out thank you cards, you need to send some of them to your haters, because they hated you enough that they got you on your knees. They got you studying the Word of God. You were built up. You made the Word your foundation because you didn't have anywhere else to go. And that's what I'm telling you, child of God, that what you thought was for your breaking, what you thought was for your destroying, is literally been the thing that makes you better. And this is what the Lord gave me, two nuggets last night. And he said, talking to me, God talking to me, he says, Steve. He didn't say prophet, he didn't say apostle, he didn't say bishop, elder, preacher, reverend, doc, or anything else. Steve, what was sent for your breaking amazingly has contributed so much to your making. I see that now. I'm walking into some things in 2016 that I suffered the pain for in 2009, 10, 11. You know, tears from previous years have turned into a wonderful harvest. Oh, Psalm 126 just popped in my head. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Now, the sowing and the reaping may not be in the same year, but I can look back to the tears that I cried in days gone by, and now they're shouts of rejoicing because, you know, what I sowed in tears, now I'm starting to reap it in joy. What was set for your breaking amazingly has contributed so much for your making. Every tear, every cry, and every moan has made you and I stronger and better. You know, folks, the enemy sends stuff to take you under, but the Lord can use those same things to deliver you over. You know, it's hard to look back at the time when you're going, well, in the season where you're going through your affliction, your adverse circumstances, your tough spot. It's tough to really grip that and embrace it. But it's the literal thing. It wasn't sent for your breaking. It was sent for your making. And this is what the Lord, as a beat clause of what he said to me last night, he says, some people have left you at the scoreboard of life. They'll look up on the scoreboard of life and they'll see that your team, the team called you, is behind. Preach, Steve. Now that's a word. And then they'll look at the scoreboard and not only see that someone's up big on you, and then they look up at the clock at what time left you have to make up the difference. Oh, this is a word. And then when they saw that there was no way that you could, in their minds, that they thought that you could come back and win, they left you right there at the scoreboard. But look, folks, but God. God can come in and even the score, and God can even come in and do it quickly. you know, when there's little time left, when the fat lady had already began to sing. As a matter of fact, there are times in your life, come on, Steve, bring the NBA in, where they brought the wine. They were ready to pop the cork bottles because they thought the team called you was already out of this thing. They had already printed up the t-shirts. They thought they had their battle with you won. But God took you. Sometimes when you had little resources, little time, little education, you were outclassed, outsized, out everything, but you were not outgotted. God and you, if God be for you, he's more than a whole world against you. The kingdom of God is laying within, is inside of you. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Folks, what you thought was for your breaking, what you thought for you was for your destroying, the thing that had you walking with your head down is literally the thing that took you to another place. Now you know, because now you know all things work together for the good. So God takes some of that nasty stuff that comes for the breaking, and he mixes it in, and it works together for your making. So there are literally bad times and bad seasons and bad dates on the calendar that have literally went to make, they all work together to make a better you, to make a greater you, to take you to another place. What was sent, the enemy sent sin some many times for your breaking, God can use for your making. I got to get some postcards ready because there are so many people that were contributing at a time and a season. And they thought what they were doing was going to contribute greatly to my breaking. But oh, let me tell you this. They did me a favor. They took me to another place. They strengthened my faith. They made me get on my knees. They made me study the book. What you did for my breaking, God used for my making. Be blessed.